application of smartphone. You believe by 2020 it will be around 790. So that will be a 3x growth. And this a look at how the different countries around this region when it comes to smartphone penetration by population. You can see that Singapore is of course leading when it comes to smartphone penetration, having more than 90%. We believe in the case of Singapore, it will be more than 100% by the end of this year. Next to Singapore, we have Australia. So of course, in the context of Philippines, at the end of 2014, it was around 30%. So that's the number for Philippines for last year. Of course, we besides Singapore and Australia leading, we also have New Zealand and Malaysia having good penetration of smartphone. And of course, as you grow in penetration, then you would, when we look at age perspective, the young ones normally have higher penetration of smartphone compared to the older generation. So the next challenge for operators in the market is how do you encourage the older generation, the 50 years old and above, to start embracing smartphone. Of course, the kids can give it as a gift to their parents, but you need to find ways to educate them on how to use it. I think those will be the next challenge. The early adopters will learn it by themselves on how to use the smartphone. But the older generation might need some guideline in terms of how to use it. Because for them, they need education. They need to be aware of what are the key benefits for them to start embracing smartphone. Is it learning about new things? Is it about getting more income or improving their livelihood? So those will be the next challenge, to find ways to encourage the late adopters to start using smartphone as well and mobile data. If you look at how we believe it will be at the end of this year, we say that at the end of 2014, it was around 30%. At the end of this year, we believe that penetration of smartphone in Philippines will be around 40%. So about 10% growth. So just now I mentioned that we also look at various data. So this is a data that comes from Mobidia, where they have on-device app. So we look at the key app from a monthly active user perspective for different countries in the region. So one commonality across the different countries in the region, we see that social network is important. We see that instant messaging is important. We see that video streaming is important when it comes to the percentage of monthly active users. When it comes to social network, it's mainly Facebook. When it comes to video streaming, it's mainly YouTube. But when it comes to instant messaging, it's quite unique from country to country. If you look at Malaysia and Singapore, WhatsApp is more common. If you look at Thailand, LINE is more popular. If you look at Indonesia, BBM continues to be popular. When it comes to Philippines, Facebook Messenger, you have Viber as well. So the top five for Philippines is Facebook, followed by Facebook Messenger, Viber, YouTube, and Instagram. And of course, if you look at the top 10, you could see navigation app becoming more popular as well. You see browsing outside of the top five. So this is based on our analysis on Android as well as iOS users. It's interesting to look at Indonesia, where we are not looking at BlackBerry users or BBM users, but BBMs continue to still be popular in Indonesia. Because even though they are using Android and iOS, they still install a BBM app. That's unique for Indonesia. In the case of Philippines, you have Viber as more popular. Of course, you can see WhatsApp down the line as well. Is this consistent with your usage, or do you use something else?
No, that's right.
Anybody using Viber in this room?
Viber.
So of course, this is very fluid. We believe that in the next update, we could see different apps coming up. So we will continue to evaluate, because we can analyze from a monthly active user perspective, from a volume perspective, from a minutes of use perspective. But this is just to give a picture from a monthly active user perspective. Here's another data that we have from Kinsula. This is based on our data from 2014. We look at among smartphone users, what are the devices that we have, from tablet as well as laptop. Among smartphone users that we talk to in the Philippines, as well as regular internet users, we can see that 48% have smartphone only. So about 50% have smartphone only among smartphone users in the Philippines, and also regular internet users. When it comes to smartphone and laptop, 20% have both smartphone and laptop. When it comes to smartphone and tablet, 15% have smartphone and tablet. Those that have all devices is 17%. But of course, this is smartphone users and regular internet users. You might have smartphone users that are not regular internet users.